Now, having learned about the chemical properties of metals, we'll now try to contrast or compare the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Yes, chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Fine. So, you know, when we began this lesson, we compared the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Now, we are trying to compare the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Now metals usually have 1, 2, or 3 electrons in their outermost shell that we all are aware of. Whereas non-metals, they generally have either 5, 6, or 7 electrons in the outermost shell. Outermost shell means the last shell, or what you call the valence shell, no? Where the valency comes from is decided by the number of electrons in the outermost shell. Now metals form positive ions. Why positive ions? Because they usually give electrons. Whenever somebody gives away electrons, it becomes positive, because electrons are negative. So imagine this, think this way. Electrons are negative things. Electrons are negatively charged particles. So when I give negative things in my life, will I become negative or positive? I'll become positive because I'm giving away negative things. Like I give away negative or bad habits, I become good or I become positive in. So metals, they form positive ions. Why ions? Whenever a metal or a non-metal, they accept or share electrons. When an element gives or takes electrons, it forms an ion. So metals, we all learned in the lower classes, metals, they give electrons or they give away their electrons. They have a tendency to give away electrons, and that's why they form positive ions. Why? Because they are giving negative things. What is the negative thing? They're giving electrons. Non-metals, they accept electrons, and that's why they form negative ions. They are accepting negative things. Negative, what are the negative things they are accepting? They are accepting the electrons. The electrons are negatively charged particles. We all know, no? Electrons are what particles? Negatively charged particles. So when a non-metal accepts electrons, it becomes negative. In other words, they form anions. So metals form positive ions. The other name for positive ions is cations. And non-metals form negative ions. The other name for negative ions is anions. And that's why you have, no, we learned that positive ions, they go to the cathode. Cations go to the cathode. Anions go towards the anode. No, when during electrolysis, the cations will go towards the cathode. Cathode is the what electrode? Negative, you know, negative electrode. And anions will go to the what electrode? The positive, no, the positive electrode. Clear? Next. Metals react with oxygen to form basic oxide. We saw, no, metals generally react with oxygen to form basic oxide. Because when you dissolve any metallic oxide in water, you get a hydroxide, no? Like for example, sodium oxide. When you dissolve sodium oxide in water, what did you get? Sodium hydroxide. When you dissolve potassium oxide in water, what did you get? Potassium hydroxide. So you got a basic oxide. You got a what oxide? Basic oxide. Non-metals react with oxygen to form acidic oxides. Generally, now there are some exceptions, I don't want to go into the detail of that. Non-metals react with oxygen to form acidic oxide. There are exceptions, even in metals, not all metals react with oxygen to form basic oxides. There are some metals who don't form basic oxides when they react with oxygen, okay? So also non-metals, they generally react with oxygen to form acidic oxides. Why acidic oxides? Because when you take a non-metal oxide, non-metallic oxide, and put it in water, you'll always get an acid. Let's say for example, I take carbon. Now when I react carbon with oxygen, what oxide do I get? I get carbon dioxide. When I mix carbon dioxide in the water, what acid do I get? I got carbonic acid. What is carbonic acid? The Pepsi and thumbs up and what you drink, that is carbonic acid. How did you get a carbonic acid? You dissolve carbon dioxide in water. What do? The layer Pepsi people, they pass carbon dioxide. They fill the juice. Inside the juice, they fill carbon dioxide and they give you. And that becomes a Pepsi or thumbs up carbonic acid. Say also, let's say there's one more acid. Let's say for example, say nitrogen. Nitrogen is a non-metal. Why? It's a gas. That's why it's a non-metal. So non-metal nitrogen reacts with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide. And when you mix nitrogen dioxide in water, what will you get? You will get a what? Nitric acid. So in other words, you are getting an acid. So whenever you mix a non-metallic oxide in water, you get an acid, and that's why we say non-metals react with oxygen to form acidic oxide. Because whenever you mix a non-metallic oxide in water, you'll always, generally you'll get an acid. Okay, generally, I'm using the word generally, because I told you there are some exceptions. I don't want to tell you how the exceptions confuse you all. Metals mostly react with water to form metal hydroxides. No, we saw just metals mostly react with water to form metal hydroxide. Like we saw in the reactions, no? Reactions of metals with water. What happened? Sodium reacted with water to form what hydroxide? Sodium hydroxide. Potassium reacted to the water to give you potassium hydroxide. Then we saw calcium reacted with water to give you calcium hydroxide. So they usually give you metal hydroxides. No, non-metals generally do not react with water except for halogens. No, only except halogens, all other non-metals will not react with what? Will not react with water. They generally will not react with water. And if you really want to see the example of this reaction, if you go to page number 98, on the top, page number 98, right on the top, reaction of non-metals with water. We see, you know, chlorine plus water giving you HOCl. HOCl is what? Hypochlorous acid. And HCl, we all know, is hydrochloric acid. But HOCl is hypochlorous acid. Okay. So you get hypochlorous acid and hydrochloric acid. So except for halogens, non-metals generally do not react with water. But metals, they react with water to give you metal hydroxides. The last one, metals mostly react with dilute acids to form metal salts and hydrogen gas. Now we saw that in the reaction, we learned metals generally react with acids to form metal salts and hydrogen gas. Which acid we saw gives you hydrogen gas? Which metals react with which acids to form hydrogen gas? Only sulfuric acid and hydrochloric acid. So metals generally react with dilute sulfuric acid and dilute hydrochloric acid to give you what? Metal salt and hydrogen gas. Remember we told you, what about nitric acid? When metal reacts with nitric acid, you don't get hydrogen gas. Instead of hydrogen gas, you get hydrogen oxide. What is hydrogen oxide? Water. We saw a reaction of metals with nitric acid. No, we learned in the previous slides. One of the previous slides, we saw metals reacted with nitric acid to give you water or hydrogen oxide. What do you call the other name for water is hydrogen oxide. So that is the thing. So remember this. So which acids metals form react with which acids to give you hydrogen gas? Only sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid. Okay. And okay, now with nitric acid, generally it will not give you hydrogen, it will usually give you water. It will give you water. What about non-metals? Non-metals generally do not react with dilute acid. Non-metals generally do not react with dilute acids. Okay. Now, except there is some exception now. Okay, there are some exceptions. Except what is that? Halogens, except halogens. Now if you go to page number 98, you learn there the chlorine, no? Chlorine is reacting with HBr. Yes or no? To give you what? HCl and Br2. Okay? So chlorine reacts with hydrobromic acid. Okay? To form hydrochloric acid HCl and bromine. And bromine is formed in the aqueous solution. Okay? So non-metals, I forgot to write it here, non-metals generally do not react with dilute acids, you will write except halogens, because we saw on page number 98 in reaction number 3, we saw chlorine, which is a non-metal, no, reacting with the acid, which acid? Hydrobromic acid to form, what is that? To form hydrochloric acid and bromine, okay, liquid bromine, because we know Bromine is found in which state? In the liquid room temperature, we find bromine in the liquid. That was then given the reaction number 3 on page 98 on the top. HCl forms plus Br2 in bracket, they are giving you AQ. AQ means aqueous. It is found in the liquid state, in the aqueous state. Okay. So with this, we finish the we finish the section on comparison of the physical properties of metals and non-metals and comparison of the chemical properties of metals and non-metals.